Dan James from Medgold is with me. Dan, good to see you.
Good afternoon.
You've this week reported back on some quite encouraging exploration results from Tlamino in Serbia. Run us through what you've been learning, what you've found.
Yeah, so down at Tlamino, our project down in the south, you know, it's under our option agreement with Fortuna Silver Mines. We've recently completed our IP, you know, geophysical survey. So, you know, we run quite a sizable project over, you know, over the main targets down in the southern parts of the license. And we've also extended our channel results. So, you know, some really good results coming out of both of those programs.
And Buddy in particular, you're seeing some quite positive results. I mean, you don't want to overplay it at this stage, but you're liking what you're seeing?
Yeah, well, the results are really very good. So the previous phase of channel sampling that we did, we took about 130-odd samples, and they were averaging, you know, about 8 grams. So it's, you know, it's whacking really, really good grade. And then some of those channels were ending in very high grade, one of which was ending in 10 grams grade. So
right.
We went back and, you know, extended the channels. We used a, you know, a diamond saw, so it was properly, you know, properly done with QAQC, and extended those channels out. So the one of note, we extended out another 40 meters from an existing 40 meter channel. So we've now ended up with about an 84 meter channel, you know, continuous sampling of 5.6 grams per ton gold with, you know, over 100 grams silver as well.
And are you suspecting there's a similar profile between Berieska and Liska?
Yeah, so the Liska occurrence is about 1.5 kilometers to the southwest of Barie. This was drilled by the Yugoslavs back in the 1980s. They defined about 7 million tons of sub-economic lead zinc mineralization with very low gold silver, and that was about 1.5% combined lead zinc. But the geological model of that is that it was a flat-lying body of mineralization. You know, it's a large tabular unit. The detachment fault out daylights on a road, which we've sampled, and then it continues undercover. So the IP surveys that we did, the geophysics, we needed to determine, you know, what the signature of the Liska thing looks like, so we could compare to Barie. So we've done that now, and you know, Liska lights up very well. It charges really well. Looks really good. But more importantly, at Barie, where we've got the very high-grade gold mineralization, we've put the, you know, the survey over that, and that's highlighted anomaly, a chargeability anomaly of about a kilometer in east-west axis and about 400 meters north-south. But probably the most exciting part of that is that sitting right on the flanks of that anomaly is the only occurrence of where that fault, the big detachment fault, daylights, is our Barie outcrop, and that's where we've got the 84 meters at 5.5 grams. So the combination of those, you know, is tantalizing to think that they're connected. We don't know. We have to be very cautious at this stage, but the assumption is that the mineralization and alteration we see at Barie is also connected with the IP anomaly. So those two combined make it a, you know, well, very exciting.
So the plan is get in and do some drilling then.
Yeah, so we you know, we're underway with you know, the planning for the drilling now. So we've got the contractor all lined up. We're going through all the landholder permissions, which is taking a little bit longer than expected, but we're working through those. There's obviously lots of, you know, little landholders that each need, you know, we need a permission from, so we're working on that. But we've agreed with Fortuna to increase the program now. So we've got about 2,500 meters budgeted. We're hoping that will be starting at the end of the summer. So
they're clearly as encouraged by this as you are.
Yeah. We're all excited. It looks good. I think, as I said before, you know, getting grade like that at surface, you know, is very, very, you know, very encouraging. Mm-hmm. And then we just need to see whether it links up with that RP anomaly. And then if it does, then that will open the doors to a much bigger program.
So looking to kick off the drill program towards the end of summer, how many holes are you looking at drilling?
2,500 meters, we'll probably get 15 holes out of that. The idea of that is to test certainly on the Barie outcrop itself, where we've got the high grade results to see whether that goes into the third dimension. There is also, you know, an adit on that was put in, you know, not sure, but quite some time ago. So we're hoping to try and get into that and have a, you know, poke around in that, but it's reported as going in, you know, tens of meters, which would give it the third dimension. So the first drill holes would be to test that outcrop in the third dimension, and then we will start working along in out towards the west, which has never been tested before. It's never been sampled. The fault hasn't been observed. So, you know, we think that it's, you know, that the detachment fault has gone under conglomerate cover, which has kind of masked the geochemical signature, has kept it blind, so you've got no outcropping mineralization. But I think the IP, you know, the geophysics has picked up something beneath the conglomerates, and you know, as the hill steepens, it looks like the the anomaly follows the detachment into the hill undercover. So that would be the objective of the drill program, run along to the west, put in a few holes there, and then also come, I think we're going to do a few holes to the north as well, you know, going deeper as the hill steepens, the holes will get a little bit longer to hit the flatline detachment, but that would be the objective. So we'll quickly do 15 holes, probably a couple of months worth of work.
Right.
But yeah, the good news is we've got 2,500 meters to test it before the end of the year.
Very nice. And how long are we going to have to sit by anxiously waiting before you report back on some of these assays?
Well, we'll report it out as quickly as we can. You know, it's in, you know, it will be very interesting. We're all, you know, waiting with bated breath to see what the first couple of holes come up with. The first holes will be sitting right on the outcrop, as I said. And so once we've commenced the drilling, you know, we'll assay those first holes straight away and get those out to the market probably in the month of, you know, within the month of starting. And then we'll, you know, incrementally release in, you know, probably bigger batches, you know, like half, you know, the second, first and second half of the programs as we go through toward the end of the year.
Excellent. So all going according to plan, all going well. Could be quite a nice way to round off 2017.
Let's hope so. It's, you know, we've put in a lot of hard work on this project now, and it's, you know, we're all very keen to see what's going to come out of the ground with the drill rig. But, you know, we have to, you know, wait for the, you know, the true tool, which is the, you know, the drill rig to see whether it is actually there. And, you know, if it is, then we go to a much bigger program for next year.
Look forward to it. Dan, good to see you. Thanks very much.
Pleasure. Thanks very much.